street.
I was set back a little bit when I first saw it.
On the phone from California, retired San Diego Chargers player Wayne Clark talks to me about the noise in his head and what may be causing it.
I'm going through some things right now that I can't distinguish from age-related issues as opposed to concussion-related. Gives me pause each time it happens.
Once only revealed after death in an autopsy, the signs of CTE, chronic traumatic encephalopathy, were clearly visible in retired NFL players.
Here are two subjects from the trial. This is subject number one. And as compared to the normal here where you have a smooth blue, a very light green appearance, you see here that there is now the appearance of darker shades of green, red and yellow, which all indicate higher concentrations of tau protein.
Memory loss, confusion, dementia, and depression, all symptoms Junior Seau had before he took his own life.
Many, many cases of CTE end in suicide.
Here's why. A buildup of protein blocks the normal function of the brain in areas associated with mood.
Sort of a sludge. It's clogging up the brain cells are not able to work, and it also indicates torn fibers that are probably irreversibly damaged. So it gives us a picture of what sort of a footprint of prior injury.
In Wayne Clark, it was a concussion he doesn't even recall that may be impacting his memory now. In the NFL CTE study, five retired players were put through a scan. First, injected with a compound that binds to tau protein. They had each played football for 20-plus years throughout their lives, and all showed abnormal levels of tau. The more concussions, the more tau protein. Signs of CTE.
When I first saw the scan, I thought, whoa, that looks pretty extensive.
And potentially widespread, considering the average football player who plays through college receives 8,000 hits to the head. It's a pattern doctors need to block.
Maybe look at using antidepressant medications. Some people believe that CTE is a chronic inflammation. So maybe anti-inflammatory pharmaceuticals, drugs, maybe anti-inflammatory dietary supplementations and diet. Maybe psychotherapy and psychiatric care.
The ultimate goal for these researchers, scan current players. If they see signs of CTE, limit exposure, offer a treatment, and reverse the course of the condition. In the absence of a treatment, though, neurosurgeons like Dr. Bales are trying to change the game and limit head hits. They've already started in the youth leagues. Back to you.